with David and Loving the Alien, it was one of those classic David phone calls to me. I get a call from him, and he's like, "Gerry, do you want to play Loving the Alien with me in Carnegie Hall next Saturday?" I'm like, "This is Tuesday." And I'm like, "Yeah, that sounds great." He says, "Great, I'd like to start it on a C minor." I was like, "Okay." And I said, "I'd like to do it with just you, just guitar, and just the two of us." I'm like, "Okay, great. I'll see you at rehearsals on Friday." Click, you know? I'm like, I go, you know, through the records, I put on Loving the Alien, and it's, you know, it's so vast in terms of its 80s production. I mean, the kitchen sink and the closets and the golf clubs are dumped in there, you know, so it's, and it's all going on. I'm like, okay. So I'm listening to it, and then I'm like, okay, let me just, you know, what I like to do is, let me just write out the harmony of this, and let me start there. And you know, when I did that, I was like, these chord changes are beautiful. And the sentiment of the song was really beautiful. And then I thought, there's one little melodic thing that, let me see if I can do this for you. So there's one little kind of melodic phrase that kept jumping out, which is this little arpeggio thing. You know, it kind of has this, kind of sets the scene in a sense. So I was using these kind of loopers at the time, and I was like, well, what if I just took that and put it out there in space? So I had this idea that I would go, and then, you know, with an acoustic guitar, just putting the chords over that. You know, it suddenly like felt like, oh yeah, this is really, you know, it's really beautiful, you know, when you stripped away all that stuff. So it's a classic example of where, you know, his writing and his harmony was always there. And that's what I've noticed with David and his writing, is he always has a very strong sense of the harmony and the melody and where that goes. And then you can dress it whatever way you want, kind of thing, you know, because it starts off with, so we have this chord, these chords, which are not uncommon, but then it goes, starts to change. Out of time thing. Bringing us to this chorus. And I think I got lucky with it, because it's a very guitar shape for the chorus. And, you know, and then I thought, maybe he wrote it that way on the guitar. I don't know. But, you know, I really felt I had to come up with something that would work on the guitar. And, you know, to accompany him. And so it ends up being this kind of beautiful thing. It's just kind of buried, you know, and that was kind of like of the time, you know, I think, to separate out every instrument, you know, in those times of recording, it was like everything had to be separated onto a separate track and remixed. And I think music just became dislocated in a sense or something, you know. But the thing is, you know, the song was always in there, And to me, all I did was find the really important parts and pull them out.
Watching them come and go, the Templars and the Saracens, the traveling the Holy Land, opening telegrams. Torture comes and torture goes, knights would give you anything, they'd bear the cross of Cordelia. Salvation for the mirror blind. Oh, but if you pray all your sins out, hooked upon the sky, pray and the heathen lie will disappear. Strangest things, loving the alien and your prayers, it breaks the sky in two. Believing the strangest things, loving the alien. Palestine, a modern problem, bounty and a wealth and land, terror in the best made plan. Watching them come and go, tomorrow's and the yesterday, Christians and the unbelievers hanging by the cross and me. But if you pray on your sins are hooked upon the sky, pray and the heathen lie will disappear. Strangest things, loving the alien, and your prayer, it breaks the sky in two. Believing the strangest things, loving the alien, you pray. Believing the strangest things, loving the alien, and your belief, you're loving the alien, believing the strangest things.